Hi, this is Gonzalo from the AWS Glue team, and today I want to show you a really powerful feature that has just been added to Glue Studio. Previously, you will typically develop your job using the AWS console, especially for visual jobs, and then once you're happy and have tested the changes to your dev account, you will need some external process to promote other environments or integrate with a pipeline that releases it into production. In the next few minutes, I will show you how Glue Studio integrates with Git in order to enhance development and streamline the deployment process. I will demo both systems supporting all release, first AWS Code Commit and then GitHub. We are now in Glue Studio, working on a job. Whether it's a visual or we are writing a script that will be saved to S3 as usual, now you have this new tab version control where you can link the job with a code repository. This in turn can be used to initiate an automatic CI/CD pipeline that deploys those changes to other accounts. In terms of version control, Git is the industry standard for source code management, so by pushing our work there, we leverage its capabilities to manage our job history, including the visual design, the script, and any job configuration we have. At release time, the repository choices are AWS Code Commit and GitHub, with other popular repositories to be added later on. In the case of AWS Code Commit, it is quite easy to set up. All we have to do is select one of the repositories available in the account. We need a branch already created, for instance, main. And finally, we can enter a path under the repository where we will store the files related to this job. And it can be also a subfolder. Now that we have configured our repository information, we can use the action to push the changes that we have in this job onto the repository so it gets versioned there. It asks us to confirm that we are uploading to the right repository, branch, and control system. If we are happy with the changes, we just confirm and the changes will get uploaded. We are now in Code Commit. And we can see that for the repository and branch selected, we have under the path specified the files that represent the job that we have saved. In this case, there's only a JSON because it's a visual job. If it was a script job, we'll have the JSON with the configuration and the separate script that contains the code. Now, the other action we have available is pull from repository. What this does is it gets the latest version from the selected branch and replaces the local job here with that version. That's something we may want to do because we want to discard the local changes or somebody make changes to the repository directly or just because we want to change the branch. In the case of GitHub, the actions work the same, but the configuration is slightly different. In this case, we have to enter a personal access token we generate at GitHub that will associate the token with the account and the permissions. We will see this later. And you also have to enter a repository owner. This is the user or their organization in GitHub that owns the repositories. Once we have entered these two things, we can list the repositories for that owner and that token. And from then, we will select the branch in a similar way. Okay, so we are now in GitHub to generate the token we need for the integration. We just have to get from the settings page to the developer settings, then personal access tokens, generate new token, enter a meaningful name that you can remember later, then select how long do you want this token to be valid for. Once it's expired, you will have to set it again in Glue Studio to keep being able to integrate. And finally, you just need the read and write permission for the package. And it will select automatically the only ones it needs. Generate the token and copy it over. Back in Glue Studio, I have entered the token I generated in GitHub, enter the repository owner, and now I can list repositories and branches and pick the one that I want to use to save this work. Once that's ready, I can push and save my changes in GitHub. Once I have pushed my changes into GitHub, I can go and check on the repository that I selected for the path I entered. My file has been changed with all the metadata and my visual job, and now I can use all the features in GitHub to check the history, maybe I want to roll back and see the times, etc. With this new feature, you can now streamline the development and deployment of your Glue jobs. Thank you for listening.